What is the Hudson River School and when was it founded?
Well, you know, often people think there's an actual school, but it really, this art movement that we now call the Hudson River School, I think it really started when Thomas Cole first arrived in the Hudson Valley.
So when did Thomas Cole first come to Catskill, New York? How did he get here?
He came up here on a steamboat in 1825, and that was the beginning. That was when, with his first paintings of this region, people just saw America in a new way. He took this sketches from this trip from right around this area, took them back to New York City, and he developed them into paintings, and then exhibited them on Broadway that same year, and they became an overnight sensation. And I don't say that lightly. I mean, they was literally in all the newspapers in New York, a favorite with all the people in the know, the powerful people in New York, virtually overnight. And some famous statements were made at that time. John Trumbull said, and I paraphrase here, this young man, Thomas Cole was only 24 at the time, this young man has done in an instant what I have labored my whole life to do. And it was paintings like no one had ever seen before.
So when did Thomas Cole leave New York City and come up here year round? Obviously he had a studio with his family in New York City in 1825. What brought him up here?
Well, he was in New York City originally, where if there was an art world at all at that time, early America, it was in New York. So he had heard about this new hotel that opened here in 1824, and it was called the Catskill Mountain House. And it was built on a precipice right at the edge of the Catskill Mountains, overlooking the entire valley. And it was starting to gain quite a bit of popularity because it was this great combination of things. A place right in what they considered to be wilderness, but with all the luxuries of home. They even had a ballroom. So it was a great a turning point for this region to have a place to stay in the middle of this scenic beauty.
And you've also started the Artist Trail, which was popularized in the New York Times last year. How's the reception been to that, and where do you take them?
That's been an incredibly popular program. So we started this program called the Hudson River School Art Trail, which is, I think it came out of the fact that we just got so many questions about where these sites are. People sort of knew that near here were some of these famous places that are in the paintings. For example, Catterskill Falls, or Catterskill Clove, there's a view, a painting you mentioned earlier by Thomas Cole called Lake with Dead Trees, which was one of the paintings that initially made him famous, and that site is right near here as well. So we got together and said we need to map these places, people need to go. A lot of them are in public parks, they're fully accessible, and the views are beautifully preserved, and it's amazing to look and see the view that's in this painting and compare. It just speaks volumes about the painting and about the view, because the view, although magnificent, the painting is even more magnificent. Cole has added a storm that comes over the mountains, he's added some rugged trees in the foreground, he's added this sense of America as being a wild and untamed place. Cole said about his painting that he wants to have nature for every object, but not every single thing in his painting is from a single view. So if you stood up there one day and took a photograph, of course he didn't have that ability, there were no photographs and cameras when he was painting, but you would never get all of those elements of his into one picture. He would go up there over and over again. Maybe he had a storm one day that he loved. Maybe another day he saw this tree, and maybe a third day he saw this perfect light on the water, and he would put them all into one picture. And he felt that that was painting a higher truth, that really to get at the truth of the matter, you had to compose the perfect picture.
Cole was a world traveler, but occasionally was known to have taken the train up to Niagara with his wife. She really enjoyed the train ride. He hated it. On that trip in 1839, he stopped off near Rochester and did what was considered to be one of his great paintings called Portage Falls of the Genesee. For some reason, the state now calls it Letchworth Gorge State Park. That painting, done in the studio right behind us, is in the collection of the William Seward House. They've decided to deaccession it and put it up for sale at Christie's, where it's expected to bring between $18 and $22 million. Were the economy stronger, it might take off. If another billionaire chases it, it could really take off. It is the largest coal ever known to come to auction of an A-plus subject matter New York State landscape in autumn with the kind of color palette you really want and come to expect for coal at its finest.